A very beautiful morning to everyone. Well, dear students, in this video today we are going to deal with two topics. That is, first is poverty estimates and second is vulnerable group. Though poverty estimates is very small topic, but it has deeper sense. Now let's start. See, so far we have studied that about poverty, that it's a basic necessities of life wherein a person cannot meet up. Then we also studied about poverty line, that it's an imaginary line through which we estimate poverty. We can also say that the people who falls below that line, it's poor, and above that line, it's non-poor. And we have also seen that there are many criteria, there are many dimensions, okay, social indicators, and there are two levels, that is level of income and level of consumption. Now let's find it out that what do you think, that poverty is same within the states, within the countries, within the city and towns? What? No, it's not. We have different poverty ratios between the countries, and even in, if you see domestic country, that is India, yes, we do have different estimation, not only state wise, not only city wise, but if you divide it between rural and urban, it still it is. So let's see the ratio. See that in 1973 to 74, you can see that rural area, the percentage of poor is 56% and urban it was 49%. So total 54. Now next, in 1994, rural area is 37 and urban is 32, and total, you know, I can say average is 36. Then in 2011 and 12, that is latest one, rural area is 26. Urban 14, total 22. So you can see that there is substantial decline in poverty from 1973 to 2011 in rural area, that is from 56% to 26%, and in urban areas from 49% to 14%. And the total average total, if you see, it's 54 to 22. So there is a substantial decrease from 1973 to 2011 in poverty. So there are many reasons behind that you will study further. Now let's start with the vulnerable groups. We have two types of groups, social and economic group. Okay, and in social group we have two, scheduled castes and scheduled tribe. Economic group, it's rural agricultural labor and urban casual labor. Now you can see the vulnerable groups, it's poverty data 2011 and 2012. You can see the indicators here. The social tribes, it's 43% scheduled tribes are poor. Scheduled caste, 29% scheduled castes are poor. 40% agricultural laborers, and 33% it's casual laborers. What do you mean by agricultural laborers? Agricultural laborers means the laborers who work in a rural area and they do not possess lands, means there is no land. Casual laborers, you can see in urban areas, the workers who work in the factories and in construction sites. So the examples of vulnerable groups, you can see they're very young and elderly people, disabled, impoverished, immigrants, indigenous groups, physically and physically isolated or marginalized, large families, single parent or travelers and tourists. These are all examples of vulnerable groups. Now, if you'll see overview of that topic, yes, poverty line is not the same for all social group and economic categories in India. It differs group to group and different economic status. So social groups which are most vulnerable to poverty are scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, and economic group, that you know, that are the rural agricultural laborer households and the urban casual laborers. The average percentage is 26. And this is all the summarization of the data. And apart from these social groups, yes, women, elderly people, female infants are systematically denied equal access to resources available to the family. This group is poorest of the poor. I hope that you liked it. And note down few important points, you can note it down. So till then, take care everyone and enjoy yourself.